Coming up on the show, with the recent release of Windows 10, we thought we'd highlight a few capabilities that benefit both Office 365 users and IT admins. From Azure AD Domain Join for single sign-in into Microsoft Cloud services such as Office 365, and the new Business Store in Windows 10, which now supports Azure AD and Org ID, to mobile device management, where Windows 10 tablets can enroll in Office 365 MDM. Stay tuned. Azure Active Directory has been the foundation for user identity in Office 365 and other Microsoft Cloud services for some time now. Windows 10 now adds Azure AD support throughout, enabling single sign-in and new management scenarios. I was joined by Michael Niehaus at Microsoft Ignite, and he demonstrated Azure AD Domain Join during the Windows 10 first run experience.
Yeah, so we want to start off with a scenario that hopefully people will be able to see, where we take a machine and join it into Azure Active Directory. So for that, we have a machine that has Windows 10 installed on it. Nothing's been done to set it up or to log in for the first time, so we can walk through the initial experience where we can then put in our Azure Active Directory credentials to join the machine directly into Azure AD. I need to sign in with my work or school account, the account that we want to use. So I can sign in with that account. It'll take a few seconds to complete the enrollment process into Azure AD and also into MDM. And at that point, it begins the first logon experience. So it will start pulsing the colors to say that this is our first logon to Windows. So we don't want to sit around and watch that for a couple of minutes, but we can at least see here that it is joining in. So why don't we fast forward this a little bit and look at a machine, this same machine actually, later, where all of this has already been configured. The joy of snapshots, we can fast forward in time. So okay. Here I can see that I'm logged on as John Smith, which is my Azure AD account. If we want some proof of that, we can start up a command prompt and we can see that that's who we are. So we can ask Windows, who am I? And it says, I am Azure AD John Smith. So it knows that I am an Azure Active Directory account. If we take that the next step and go into settings, we can go to accounts, and then work or school, and we can see that this machine is already enrolled in the organization's MDM solution. So in this case, it is being provided by Intune. And more importantly, because it's a company device that's being signed into using an Azure AD account, there's no remove option. That's been disabled as well, because we want this to remain a managed device. So that's all it takes. We just put in our ID and password once, it sets everything up, it pushes down policies, it even pushes down applications. In this case, the Intune company portal is already on the device and ready to use.
So that was Azure AD Domain Join, but it doesn't end there. With Windows 10, you're able to better manage the business store experience for your organization and authenticate into it with Azure AD for your organization. For Office 365, this also means the ability to manage and provision Office mobile apps from the business store.
So we'll go to businessstore.microsoft.com, which will ask us to sign in. So this is basically the web page that the IT administrator uses. They'll sign in using an admin account that's used to acquire apps for their organization. In this case, I'll use admin at contosoincorporated.com. So I sign in as the administrative account, and then I can acquire applications for the organization. So I see pretty much the standard store experience, so I can see all the applications that are available to acquire for the organization. In this case, maybe I want to get the modern version of PowerPoint to put on my machine or in my image, whatever. So I can specify that I want that to be available offline, and I want to get the application. It asks me for confirmation, basically says, okay, you're going to use your own management tool to distribute this, so the store is not going to be doing that for you. So I'll go ahead and confirm that. And at that point, it will take me to my inventory of acquired applications and licenses and show me that now I have PowerPoint licensed for my organization for offline use. At that point, I could go ahead and download the pieces, or if I'm using Config Manager vNext, just go to Config Manager. It talks to the store, shows me my complete list of apps, and I just check off the ones that I want. We could also do licenses tied to Azure AD accounts. So in this case, I have a line of business application that I've submitted to the dev portal. So I'm a developer in my organization. I created the app. I uploaded it just like any other application, but I said make it available only to members of my organization.
Okay.
So it shows up here, and then we could assign it to individual accounts. So using Azure AD, we can see all the accounts that are there and directly assign this application to a user. The user then gets a notification that says, you have an application available, click here to install it. We can also manage these licenses as the organization. We could say, maybe Stephen Carr doesn't work here anymore. So we can select that one and say that we want to revoke that license, reclaim that license, and use it for someone else. We can also make these apps available through a private store within the public store. So we can just specify that we want this to show up in the private store, which is as easy as clicking a link, which says publish this application so that my end users can see it and install it using self-service.
And that's only for the ones that can authenticate with their Azure AD credentials, right?
Anyone who signed in with the organization's Azure AD account would be able to see the application and click to install it. We'll also provide additional policies for the Windows Store to let you turn off some of the public information. Maybe you don't want games to be available in your organization,
right.
So turn that off. Show the curated organization list and let the employees select apps from there.
So as we just saw, the org ID support with Azure AD and new business store features provide a more manageable solution for authenticated application curation of store apps and targeted provisioning for your organization. But one last thing I want to show you is actually a demonstration of how we can enroll Windows 10 tablets into Office Mobile Device Management using Azure AD Join. So here I have my Surface, and I'll show you just the process that I do in order to join that. So the first thing I do is get into my Settings menu. I'm going to click on Accounts. Then I'll click on the Work Access tab, and there we'll see the ability to be able to join an Azure AD domain. So when I do that, I'm going to go ahead and click that, click Continue. And now I have the ability to actually type in my Office 365 account, Alex D in this case, at mechanics.onmicrosoft.com. I'll go ahead and click Join. And what that's going to do is it's actually going to broker a connection between this Surface Pro 3 full Windows desktop computer into Office 365 MDM. So here I'm going to sign into my Office 365 admin console. To do that, I'm going to use my admin account. We'll type in a password. Once we log into the admin portal, we'll be able to see whether or not this device is actually joined into MDM. So with that, with the admin portal, I'll be able to click on mobile devices, and then that will actually show me, in this case, Alex D, Alex Darrow, camera one, the name of this PC, and Windows 10 is actually joined into Office 365 MDM. So now I have the ability, another option, to manage this device like I would manage some other mobile device platform. So really cool, really new options in order to manage Windows 10 in a different way. So if you haven't already upgraded to Windows 10, what we've shown are just a few new options to complement the traditional management controls in Windows, plus a few new ones to look forward to. Of course, all this information and more can be found as it hits on the Office blog and Wednesdays on Office Mechanics. Thank you for watching, and goodbye for now.